Let's get started by finding our project and starting our virtual machine. Open a terminal window in Visual Studio Code and log into Azure with your credentials. Let's copy the public IP address and use it to secure Shell into our virtual machine. Make sure you enter your project administration username and password that we set up in the previous exercise. Our first step is to update the package and repository information. Our next step is to install Nginx, which is our web server, and Python, which will run our web server. Let's now set up the reverse proxy configuration of our Nginx web server so that our client requests can be handled. Let's open a new terminal window and navigate to the Sites Available directory and take a peek at what's currently there. As you can see, the default file looks very similar to our reverse proxy configuration file. Our next step is to unlink this file from our Nginx as the preferred reverse proxy configuration. Go ahead and open a new terminal window and log into Azure again. Let's use Secure Copy to copy our reverse proxy configuration file to our home directory on our virtual machine. Let's switch back to our Secure Shell terminal window and see our file is now in our home directory. Next, I'm going to use the sudo command to move my reverse proxy configuration file to the Sites Available directory. And yes, you do need to use sudo because it is an elevated permission area. Let's go there now. As you can see, our reverse proxy configuration file is now available in this directory. So let's go ahead and link it. We're going to link it to the Nginx server, so it is going to use that as preferred proxy configuration. In order to make all this magic work, you do need to restart the Nginx service. Okay, let's find our IP address and navigate to our website. Ooh, it's a bad gateway error, which is mysterious to many people, and I'm going to explain how to fix it. Let's take a look at our proxy file and think about what's going on here. It's listening and wanting to see something. Let's give a hint. It might be in the web app directory. Our last step is to actually start the web app, and to do that we're going to use Python. And so what we're doing now is creating the Python environment and installing any Python dependencies for packages. These package requirements are actually in our web app project. If you were to take a look, you would see them listed there, and we have to install them. The last step is to actually run the Python application. And as you can see, it's now listening on our local host, and we refreshed our web browser, and voila! We have a Flask application running on our virtual machine. Congratulations! Don't forget, after you're done playing with your virtual machine, stop it so you don't get charged any more money than you want to.